kids, welcome back to our online classes. So as I told you on the previous class that we are going through a sort of revision classes as we are done with our syllabus, as it's been completed. So now we have to deal with the classes with some of the topics that are already done and that's a completed, but yet we need to give it touch and we need to continue the learning, don't we? Yes. So on the basis of that idea, I thought why not try something very easy and something that you are very comfortable with. That's why I choose the very last piece, and it is page number 48 from Active English Workbook. So usually we need to have that Active English Workbook when we especially we are doing exercises from workbook. Okay, so to say, today again we need to have that book at our hand, and of course along with our pencil and eraser. Okay babies, so on the previous class we solved 6 of the questions that were in fill in the gap types pattern. Now we are going to solve more, 6 more questions. Okay, these are also in the form of fill in the gaps. You will have gaps here and you need to just fill the gaps. So that's nothing actually tough for you. I know you can make it out. Okay, so on the sequence of that class, on the basis of 48, page number 48, it's now the second part. Okay, as you can see, Miss has already written the questions on the board, but you don't need to write the questions again, as in the book you are already given the questions. The questions are given here, babies. You just need to follow the questions and listen to Miss's answer so that you can match the answers. You can have the similarities between answers. Okay, baby. So you don't need to pay much heed to my writing on the board. You just need to go through the questions in the book and you just need to follow the answers only. Okay, babies. So let us get started. Here on the board, I have mentioned the page number. Okay, as page number is the most important thing here, because workbook and Active English book and Active English workbook, this book are quite similar. One is, your theory book, and another book is like a practical book. That's it. So you really need to know specifically actually which of the book that we are dealing with. Okay, baby. So as a number till the number 6 we have already done on the previous class. So for today's class we will start with which number? 7. From 7 to 12 we will now today we are going to solve 7 to 12 number questions. So number 7, it's a question like, how many boys are there in your class? Can you find the question in your book? Look at the book. The question is, how many boys are there in your class? That means, so you can write, the answer will start with writing there. Okay, here the subject is there. There, the auxiliary verb will, as I told you that, the auxiliary verb is will be used for singular number. If, in your class, is there only one boy? No, there are so many handsome boys in your class. Okay, so I can't write is. We know our boys are very talented and very intelligent, like Karuno, Todhit, Khyati Joy, Monjoy. They all are really very talented and very intelligent boys, Kutir. So we just can't put is, as we have a lot of boys in our class. A lot of means it's of course plural number. So for plural number we need to mention the auxiliary verb are, not is. So what should I put here? I should put are here. So there are how many boys? There are 14 boys. 14 boys, you can just mention the figure, in digit, it's 14 boys. Or if you want to just write in word, if you want to spell it in, so you can write okay, 14, there are 14 boys, okay, you just can write in this way. In your class, you can add in your class, as you don't have much place, so you can just write till there are 14 boys, okay, babies, okay. But if you want to add something else, like there are 14 boys in my class, okay, or in our class, you can also write them. But you are not actually having the scope, then you can manage by writing till 14 boys, okay. It's also correct, okay. And you know, it is very simple, and simplicity sometimes is very smart thing to do. So now, number 8, where is the teacher's desk? Remember, where is your teacher's desk basically? Where is it, placed? The teacher's desk is basically before your eyes, okay, in front of you. So you can write the teacher's, please note the answers down. The teacher's desk is in front means before, okay, in front of us, that means it is before your eyes. Can't you see your teacher's desk in front of your eyes? Yes, see, when Miss checks your homeworks or your copies, then you just sit before Mrs. We sit face to face, so that I can be here before your eyes and you can be here also before my eyes, okay. That means I sit in front of your eyes, or I stand up in front of your eyes, so the desk is also in front of your eyes. So you have to write the desk is in front of us, because if Miss sits just behind you, your seat, can you follow Miss? No, you can never follow Miss. So I have to sit in front of your eyes or before your eyes, okay. So you need to write the teacher's desk is in front of us, okay, babies. So please write the answers down. Number 7, how many boys are there in your class? There are 14 boys. Where is the teacher's desk? The teacher's desk is in front of us, okay. What is on the wall? Now coming to the next question, it is what is on the wall? That means there is something on the wall. Can you see anything on the wall in your classroom? Yes, there is a calendar, and there basically there can be a lot of things, but here the auxiliary verb is, so it is about singular number. That means it is only asking about one thing that is placed on the wall, or that is hung up on the wall, okay. What is on the wall? You can write there is a calendar or picture, okay, or is a board. Can't you see a board on the wall? Okay, you can also write board, or you can also write picture, or you can also write calendar, okay. There is a picture, okay. I like pictures, so I wrote picture. There is a picture on the wall, or you can write there is a board on the wall, or there is a calendar on the wall, okay. So please note, there is a picture on the wall, or there is a calendar on the wall, or there is a board on the wall, okay. What color is the blackboard in your classroom? Do you have any blackboard? Unfortunately, basically we have the whiteboard in all of our classes, but here it is asking about blackboard. If it is about black, so surely and definitely the board is in black color, okay. So we can write that the blackboard is blackboard. It is not whiteboard. So as it is blackboard, so we need to write the color as black, okay. The blackboard is black. Or you can also ordinate the sentence, the answer, in the way that the color of the blackboard is black, okay. Number 11, it is asking that what are you doing now? That means it is asking about an activity that you are now going through or you are now performing. Okay, so it is. So I would like to ask you to note the answers down. How many boys are there in your class? There are 14 boys. Okay, there. Where is the teacher's desk? The teacher's desk is in front of us. What is on the wall? There is a picture on the wall. What color is the blackboard? The blackboard is black. So now coming to the next one, it is asking that what are you doing now? That means at this moment. So when we have ing form with the verb, when we have ing with this verb, what is it? We have already learned that ing means it is continuous. And if you can see the auxiliary verb am, is, are, then of course it is present continuous. Okay, if there is ing, that is undoubtedly auxiliary verb. Undoubtedly a continuous tense. And if there is am, is, are as auxiliary verb, then no doubt it is present continuous. Okay, what are you doing now? As I am writing now, so I can write I am. What are you doing? I hope you are also now writing. So I am writing now. Or you can just write now I am writing. Okay. What have you in your pocket? As I know, Karuna always keeps something in his pocket, but not everyone is like him. Okay, so basically Miss also doesn't have any pocket, so I can write anything that I have anything. Okay, so no, I have nothing. Or you can write I have a sticker in my pocket. Okay, so I know some of you keep a sticker, or you can just write that I have nothing means, that means you don't have anything, your pocket is empty. Okay, so I have nothing. Okay, so I hope that you got the ideas that how you can write. So once again, see, what are you doing now? I am writing now. What have you in your pocket? I have nothing, or I have a sticker in my pocket. Okay, so that's all for today. Please note the answers down. If you have any question, you can ask me without any hesitation. I will surely answer you and I will give the feedbacks. Okay, so we will meet very soon on the next class. Till then, stay well and take care.